guys recently released part one of the Parallax series.
Yeah.
Hyper Seek Dialogues. Can you tell us a little bit about the album?
It rules. I like it a lot. Three songs.
Yeah, three songs, 30 minutes. Each song, I guess, is about 10 minutes long.
I was going to ask if you could give us some details about the concept of the albums.
The first part is basically just we introduce two characters. One is on Earth, who's actually the character from Swim to the Moon, which is the last song, Mr. X. And so it starts out with him. He's basically on this kind of like suicidal mission, drifting out to sea. He decides he wants to leave everything behind, never be heard or seen from again. So he just basically ventures out into the ocean. And as he's kind of going in and out of consciousness, he becomes sort of subconsciously aware of this other character. And it's kind of vague, you know, there so far it's very vague. But he becomes aware of this other person, or whatever, that exists on a different planet, in a different realm of time, millions of light years away. So in the EP, it kind of jumps back and forth between those two characters. That character on the other planet becomes sort of subconsciously aware of our Earth character. And so they become aware of one another in this weird kind of way. And the EP kind of talk about them struggling with their own personal situations. And so then basically a couple things happen. And then, but really the action picks up when they do part two, which is when they're at the characters like they meet one another in a physical sense, using space and time travel type of stuff. But it's pretty cool. But basically, like the first part is pretty vague. It's just basically an introduction to these two characters, kind of where they're at in their lives, and that's about it, really.
Have you guys started writing or recording part two yet?
No, not yet. But I think I'm kind of looking forward to it. I mean, I don't have any ideas musically, but I like writing, so we'll probably get on that in the summer and start writing.
Cool. How does writing normally work? Does one guy come up with the majority of the riffs, or do you guys kind of like jam it out as a collective?
Everybody writes
individually. Everybody writes individually, and then from there it kind of becomes like this sort of meeting frenzy. We just feed off each other's ideas, or at least we try to. And that's how we end up with our songs, you know, kind of the dynamics that we have in one song. It's really because we're all just kind of feeding off everybody else's ideas. And,
everyone writes really different, too.
Yeah.
Lots of different inspiration.
Yeah.
On average, how long does it normally take you guys to write a song like Lunar Wilderness or Ants in the Sky?
I feel like that this last one was kind of fast.
Yeah, this last one was kind of fast. Kind of came together.
I feel like it took like two practices per song.
It may have taken a little more than that, because there's also like communication when we're not in the room together, you know, we'll email ideas or whatever. But yeah, this last record went pretty quickly. But you changed it too. Yeah, we changed stuff here and there. But
last week.
So I mean, it just depends really. But you know, we've had songs in the past that have taken quite a while. But,
yeah.
You know, a couple weeks maybe per song.
Recently you guys got a Metal Blade. Is there any reason why you departed from Victory and chose Metal Blade?
The contract was out. It finished our work with Victory. We kind of did our end of the bargain. And we just thought it was a good opportunity to pursue another option. You know, we had some good years on Victory or whatever, but
it did, of course.
Yeah, Metal Blade is just a better fit for us. I mean, we're where we're at right now. Not to say that, you know, back when we signed to Victory, that was probably our best option at the time. But, you know, right now it's just the way we're going musically and stuff. Metal Blade was on the same page and it just worked out.
I remember a few years ago in an interview you guys talked about re-releasing Alaska with a different mix. Is your Metal Blade switch going to affect that at all, or is that going to happen?
That'll never happen.
Yeah, it's never.
Okay. There's just too much red tape.
Okay. Well, I got some questions about your other projects. First, I'm going to talk about Tommy's project, Pulse. How would you guys compare Pulse to his original solo album, the classic electronic album, Giles?
That's way different than that, I would say. I think Giles is more just like, just something fun to do or whatever. I think this new record is more... more personal songs for him. And he worked over Mother Course over a span of a few years, so it was just kind of a collection of songs that he was doing over a period of time, and kind of more, I guess, reflected his like songwriter side. And so I think it's good. It's a good record.
You're playing guitar for them live? You're doing
the guitar? I did the guitar. I played the live show. So.
And I have a question from Dusty. Is there any news on Glass Casket? Can we ever expect another album?
Yeah, I mean, sure. We just don't have time to do shit, right? And if we do, you know, other guys are doing other stuff. I know that we'll do another record. It's just, I mean,
it's not a matter of if, it's a matter of when.
But we played a show last October. It was pretty fun. Pretty good turnout. But, you know, like I said, with this easy band takes up a lot of time. So it's kind of the priority.
Are there any bands that you guys have been currently jamming?
No. New Devin Townsend.
New Devin Townsend?
Which isn't out yet.
Yeah.
We're cool with him, so like, we got it.
I hear it's really good so far.
New Alison Krauss came out.
Yeah, that's
really
awesome.
Good.
Yeah, that was cool.
What else? Go Mavericks.
All right, well, thanks
for giving me your time. It's NBA playoff time, man. I'm not listening to music watching games.
Well, thanks for giving me your time, dude.
Yeah, man.
I really appreciate it.
No problem.
Make sure to pick up the new album, Hypersleep Dialogues.
Yeah, check it out. It's good.
Go see Between the Bear and Me and Job for Cowboy and Ocean on their tour.
Yes.
And about four more shows.
Yeah, I guess four more shows.
Oh, cool.
Hopefully you live in either Tulsa, Atlanta, Nashville, or Asheville. Otherwise, you'll be driving cars.
Check it out.